If you haven't seen any of the other parts of this series yet, go check them out, leave a like, a comment, and don't forget to share. If you're enjoying this series so far, leave a like, a comment, and don't forget to share. And if you haven't already, click the subscribe button and click the notification bell. With everything out of the way, time to continue the Intercontinental legacy. Drew McIntyre was a one-time Intercontinental Champion, with his reign lasting 161 days, one of the longer individual reigns with the belt in the second half of the Intercontinental Championship's existence. Drew, during his initial run with the company, was dubbed the Chosen One, given the seal of approval on television by Vince McMahon himself. Just a few months in, Drew won his first championship in the company, the Intercontinental Championship. After feuding with John Morrison for some time, McIntyre won the IC title at the first ever TLC pay-per-view in 2009. He feuded with Morrison for a bit afterwards. He even feuded with Kane for a pay-per-view, defeating the Big Red Machine at Elimination Chamber 2010. Drew would keep racking up win after win after win. Any losses would be nullified due to Vince McMahon forcing GM Teddy Long to do so. McIntyre would qualify for Money in the Bank at WrestleMania, not winning it, though the way the story was going, you thought that he might have won the briefcase that year. McIntyre would feud with Matt Hardy, absolutely annihilating him one week, leading to GM Teddy Long suspending McIntyre and stripping him of the Intercontinental Championship. That was nullified by Vince, the belt returning to the now unsuspended Drew McIntyre. Drew would lose the Intercontinental Championship to Kofi Kingston at the Over the Limit pay-per-view in May, and Drew might have held it over 150 days, but really, there wasn't really much to McIntyre's reign with the Intercontinental Championship, which was the start of the trend over the last decade with the belt. Guy holds the Intercontinental Championship for a good chunk of time, but they do absolutely nothing with him as champion. Dolph Ziggler was a six-time Intercontinental Champion, having reigns of 160, 35, 56, 22, 37, and 62 days respectively. He's one of only five wrestlers ever to hold the Intercontinental Championship at least six times. His 372 combined days as champion is good for 12th all-time in the history of the Intercontinental Championship, and that 372 combined days as champion is good for third most combined days as champion during the 2010s. After chasing the Intercontinental Championship for a year, Dolph Ziggler finally won the IC title for the first time on July 28, 2010 at a SmackDown taping when he defeated Kofi Kingston. The two battled over the Intercontinental Championship for the next two pay-per-views, Ziggler retaining both times, one by no contest at SummerSlam, the other defeating Kofi at Night of Champions. Then at Hell in a Cell, he was on the losing end of a six-man tag on the Dark match. That shows how much they gave a shit about the Intercontinental Championship during that time. He had a run of three interpromotional matches with Daniel Bryan in late October, losing all three of those matches. Dolph wouldn't get a pay-per-view win until Survivor Series when he retained the Intercontinental Championship against NXT Season 2 winner Caval, better known to fans as Low Key. As what became tradition from 2010 all the way to today, when in doubt, feud them with one another. And by the end of 2010, Dolph Ziggler was feuding again with Kofi Kingston. The two, along with Jack Swagger, had a triple threat ladder match at TLC that year, with Ziggler retaining the belt before Kofi Kingston won the Intercontinental Championship back in early January during a SmackDown taping. It would be 3.5 years before Dolph Ziggler would win the Intercontinental Championship again. Feuding with The Miz during the late summer, early fall of 2014, Dolph Ziggler would defeat The Miz at SummerSlam to win his second Intercontinental Championship. A month later at Night of Champions, he dropped the belt to Miz. The next night on Raw, Dolph Ziggler would defeat Miz once again to win the Intercontinental Championship for a third time. That third reign with the belt came to an end in the lead-up to Survivor Series that year, more specifically, the lead-up to Team Cena versus Team Authority. Luke Harper would defeat Dolph Ziggler on the Go Home to Survivor Series to win the Intercontinental Championship. And Dolph Ziggler would defeat Luke Harper at TLC 2014 in a highly underrated ladder match to win his fourth Intercontinental Championship. At the start of 2015, feeling the wrath of the Authority, Dolph Ziggler was forced in a match against Bad News Barrett, initially winning the match. However, Director of Operations Kane made the match 2 out of 3 falls. In the end, Bad News Barrett would defeat Dolph Ziggler to win the Intercontinental Championship, and it would be over a year before Ziggler would get another reign with the IC title. Once again, he was feuding with The Miz. After failed chance, after failed chance, after failed chance, Dolph Ziggler got one more chance at the Intercontinental Championship, and at No Mercy 2016, it was title versus career, The Miz versus Dolph Ziggler, where Dolph Ziggler would win the Intercontinental Championship for a fifth time, defeating The Miz in an excellent Intercontinental Championship match. Ziggler would lose the title back to Miz on SmackDown 900 in November. In June 2018, Dolph Ziggler would win his sixth and most recent Intercontinental Championship during Seth Rollins' IC Open Challenge. The two would continue to feud over the belt the majority of the summer last year, even main eventing Extreme Rules 2018 in a highly controversial Iron Man match. Dolph Ziggler would end up losing the Intercontinental Championship to Seth Rollins at SummerSlam that year. Now, I don't really know where to put Ziggler among Intercontinental Champions in the history of the belt. On one hand, he held it 6 times, one of only 5 to ever do so. On the other hand, none of his reigns were really memorable. On one hand, he had really good matches for the Intercontinental Championship. And on the other hand, those were him winning the belt, not defending it. It is really up to you how you decide Ziggler's fate with the Intercontinental Championship, where you would rank him among the best or wherever in the history of the championship. For someone who held the Intercontinental Championship as many times as he did, and held it for a decent amount of time combined, Wade or Bad News Barrett, whatever you want to call him, his time as Intercontinental Champion just seems to be there. Barrett was a 5-time Intercontinental Champion, having reigns of 89, 99, 69, 57, and 83 days respectively. His 397 combined days as champion is the second most combined days as Intercontinental Champion during the 2010s. Wade Barrett's first Intercontinental Championship win came shortly before WrestleMania 27, defeating Kofi Kingston on March 22nd during a SmackDown taping. And Barrett, during his first reign as Intercontinental Champion, he went on a bit of a losing streak. In fact, during his 5 times as Intercontinental Champion, in terms of as their time as Intercontinental Champion, I don't think anybody lost as many times as Wade Barrett did during their run as Intercontinental Champion, because this first run as champion, he was on the losing effort of an 8-man tag match at WrestleMania that year, a match that, by the way, went 93 seconds. He lost a ton of multi-man matches during this time. He lost to Rey Mysterio on an episode of Raw. He lost a tag title match at Extreme Rules. He lost by disqualification at Over the Limit before losing the Intercontinental Championship to Ezekiel Jackson at Capital Punishment in June. Barrett didn't get another reign with the Intercontinental Championship until the end of 2012, when he defeated Kofi Kingston once again to win the Intercontinental Championship. Barrett's second reign went a little better than the first because he actually won during this reign as champion. But then he went on a losing streak, and then a little bit of a winning streak, and then a losing streak again. He started a feud with NXT newcomer Bo Dallas, but that really never went anywhere other than the live events. On the pre-show to WrestleMania 29, Barrett lost the Intercontinental Championship to The Miz, then regained the belt the day after on Raw to win his third Intercontinental Championship. His third reign with the belt was more pretty much of the same. He won some, then he lost a ton, eventually losing the Intercontinental Championship in a triple threat match at Payback 2013 to Curtis Axel. In a surprisingly really good match, now Bad News Barrett would win his fourth Intercontinental Championship against Big E at Extreme Rules 2014. Now his fourth reign with the Intercontinental Championship was actually going better than his first three reigns combined. The fans were starting to turn him babyface and everything was looking good for him. It's like, holy crap, they actually have something with Barrett now. But like a ton of his time, pretty much the majority of his run with the company, something derailed it. And an injury in late June forced Wade Barrett, now Bad News Barrett, to vacate the Intercontinental Championship. Barrett would get the Intercontinental title back for a fifth time in early 2015 when he defeated Dolph Ziggler on an episode of Raw in a 2 out of 3 falls match. This reign was more like the first three reigns. He losses, more losses. He even had the belt stolen from him. He would lose the Intercontinental Championship officially at WrestleMania 31 in a ladder match. And Barrett, you know, look, he might have been a 5-time Intercontinental Champion, but his time with the belt, you remember loss after loss after loss. Granted, his fourth reign with the belt had potential, had a lot of potential. But again, like a lot with Barrett during his run with the company, all momentum was derailed. In a lot of ways, he held it a while, nothing really came from it. Ezekiel Jackson was a 1-time Intercontinental Champion with his reign lasting 51 days, which is probably 51 days longer than what a ton of people remember, because in terms of forgettable Intercontinental Champions in history, Big Zeke is at or near the top of that list. He won the belt at Capital Punishment from Wade Barrett, he defended it a few times, then he lost it to Cody Rhodes on August 9th at a SmackDown taping. Really? I mean, what else is there? Guys like the Mountie and even Dean Douglas are more memorable as Intercontinental Champions than Ezekiel Jackson is.